everyone, I'm Colby Carr. I'd like to begin with a quote. The people must remain ever vigilant against tyrants masquerading as public servants. This is by George Washington. And it pertained to whether or not term limits are needed to have an effective democracy. And the answer to that is yes. And George Washington agreed with me. Congress has been able to wield tyrant-like power with their ability to continually get reelected into office and not have any term limits. So in order to give you a sense of how this is being affected in Congress today, currently 10% of the 100 senators have over 34 years in the Senate. Along with that, there are 10 representatives in the House of Representatives with over 30 years. This is a large number of people in a small body of Congress that are wielding so much power that they're muting the voice of the people. And this is for two reasons. One, because of campaign finance, and two, their lack of term limits allow them to shut down any effective voice of the people and just stick with what they want to do. So as far as campaign finance goes, currently the re-election rate of Congress is at 90%, and this is despite the 14% approval rating of Congress. And this is all from the Cato Institute. So incumbents outspend their opponents typically 5-1. And this is for a few reasons. First, they're able to use their name recognition of already being elected, as well as receive fundraising and lobbying from people they've met through their work in Congress. There are many powerful people in Washington, D.C., and they're able to utilize those people in order to be elected back home. Also, there's a thing called the franking privilege, which is where incumbents do not have to pay for any mail that they send while they're in office. And this applies to mail that they can use campaigning. So while they already have more effective means to raise funds to these big outside lobbyists, they also save money on any mailers or anything they do to campaign, while anybody who's trying to get a seat at incumbent has to pay out for all that out of pocket and really start from the grassroots up in order to fundraise. And what this leads to is essentially these up-and-coming people trying to challenge the incumbents with a very small chance of ever getting their name out and getting their voice heard in the manner that the incumbent can do, which leads them to being continually reelected. So moving on, the incumbents have a strong ability, because of their nature of being in Congress already, to mute the voice of the people. A Gallup poll the percent of people who would vote for term limits is the following. Republicans, 82%. Democrats, 79%. And independents, 65%. Every major party in the United States wholeheartedly wants term limits to be imposed. The polls have showed this year after year after year. However, in order for any term limits to be enacted, they must go through Congress, effectively meaning that Congress would have to vote themselves out of office. Many bills have been introduced, none have gained traction, none have been even close to passing. So while clearly these Gallup polls show Americans want term limits, they want a limit of these tyrannical-like people in office for 30-plus years, it has to go through them in order to get approved, and obviously this will never happen. This government was established by the Founding Fathers as an effective democracy, effective government. And like I already quoted with George Washington, many of them were very, very opposed to term limits of any kind. Before there was even the 22nd Amendment limiting the executive office to 2 terms, George Washington set the precedent of limiting that to himself, which was followed all the way up into the 1950s with the New Deal. So, continuing on to that, Thomas Jefferson said, there's a necessity of rotation for the office in order for democracy to be effective. So in essence, with the excessive campaign finance rules and regulations causing them to outspend their incumbents or outspend any challengers, and their no term limits, or their ability to enact term limits through Congress themselves, the incumbents have effectively limited democracy in Congress.